Good morning, everyone. From today, we are starting our online classes. Today, I am going to take the lecture of economics for the first chapter, and the name of the chapter is Graphs in Economics. Now, students, what is the importance of diagram and graphs in economics? In our day-to-day life, we use this word diagram. From many things we come to know what a diagram is. For example, when we are walking on the road, we see the hoarding or board where horns are made and it has been cancelled. That means you don't have to horn on those places because they are there. You cannot, there may be a school nearby the road or there can be a hospital. And so from this diagrams we can make out that we don't have to do such things. Now, in general, the meaning of diagram is a representation of observable data by way of a picture. From pictures you can make out that what the diagram wants to say. For this, you don't require much knowledge of mathematics or science. Just from the diagram, you can make out what they are wanting to say to you. Now, what does a graph mean? A graph is a drawn for statistical information which is not self-explanatory. That means it has been mentioned, it has been drawn with the help of collection of data. For example, how you come to know what is the population of India. So different kinds of data are there which make you understand that whether the economy of a country is going high, low and so on. Now the second topic in this chapter is types of diagrams. There are different kinds of diagrams that you have learned till now. In maths also you have seen and drawn the graphs. Now in economics you will find different kinds of diagrams. The first type is time-based diagram. In time-based diagram, what is the main important thing? In time-based line diagram, here you can see the datas are given for different year. For example, from 1951 to 61, the percentage of growth of India's population was 21.64. In the year 1961 to 71, the percentage of population was 24.80. In 71 to 81, it rose to 24.66. In 81 to 91, it went down to 23.87. In 91 to 2001, it again reduced to 21.54. And in 2001 to 2011, it has reduced to 17.64. Now you are having the data of different years in percentage form. If I want to draw the same data on a time-based diagram, then I will draw x-axis and y-axis. For example, here in the graph on horizontal you will take x-axis, this is x-axis and this is y-axis. On x-axis every time you are able to take years. On x-axis the years are mentioned. For example, 1951 to 61, year we were having the first year 1951 to 61. The second year is 1961 to 71, 71 to 81, and so on you will carry on. Now the percentage, India's population in percentage, For the year 1951 to 61, it is 21.64. Okay, so here on the y-axis we have taken population, on x-axis we have taken years, and on y-axis we have taken population, which is in percentage. So for 1951 to 61, it's given 21.64. So here the point is 21.64 for the year 1951 to 61. Same way for 1961 to 71, the population is given 24.28. Here you can find 20, after that 25, 30. Students, please remember, whenever you are taking the percentage, your percentage should go in a sequence. For example, here it is 0, 0 to 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, and so on. The difference should be equal. You cannot take unequal distribution. You should have equal distribution of percentage. So for the second year 1961 to 71, it is 24.80. It will come somewhere here below 25. Here you can find 25, below it is 24. From here if you take one line, and from here one line, so it will come somewhere here in this point. So on you will check for the 71 to 81, that is 24.66, again 20. Here it will go for 1971 to 81, below 25, right below 25 it will be 24.66 somewhere here. And so this way you can draw the time based line diagram on the graph paper. Here I have drawn on the single line work page, but it will be drawn on the graph paper as you draw earlier. Now second kind of diagram is simple bar diagram, and it's different types. As the name suggests, simple means there is a single bar. This is called bar. This is called bar, and as you can see, there is only one single bar for each month, January to February. Here you can see that here the months are given: January to February, March to April, May to June, July to August, September to October, November to December. How much was the sale for the month of January to February? It was 35 units. And so for the month of January to February, we have taken, here again you have to remember to take the scale of same difference, 0 to 20, after 20 it will be 40, then 60, then 80, it will go on. So for the month of January to February it is 35, and so for January to February we are having 35 units sale of any unit. You can say it can be the number of milk, it can be the number of biscuits, chocolates, anything. So here how many products are sold in the month of January to February? 35 units. For the month of March to April, how many units are there? 60. And so for the month of March to April we have taken 60. After 40, 2 units, it will come 60. For May to June, it is 65. And then from July to August, it is 40. And so on, you can draw for September to October, that is 50. November to December, it is 30. So from the data, you can make out which is the lowest number of units sold in which month. It is November to December, and the number of units are 30. And where we are having the highest number of sale? in the month of May to June, which is 65 units we have sold. So this is called simple bar diagram, as there are single bar. For all the months we are having one single bar, and this diagram is called simple bar diagram. Now the next diagram is cluster bar diagram. As the name suggests, and you can see in the drawing, that there are three single bars which are attached together, which are joined together, and so it becomes cluster bar diagram. Again here, again the datas are given from January to February, and there are three different diagrams, that is small size, medium size and large size. For example, these are the number of chocolates sold. How many chocolates were sold in the month of January to February which were of small size? There were 30 units. How many chocolates were sold of medium size? They were 15. And large size chocolates of 25 units were sold in the month of January to February. So here we are having three different size of the chocolates. For example, small size chocolate, medium size chocolate and large size chocolate. And for these three different chocolates, we are having three different bars. First one is dark one, that is small size chocolates. Then this lined one shows the medium size chocolate, and the vertical line shows the large size chocolate. All the three bars should have different, either you can differentiate with the colors, with the lines, or you can keep them one of them blank, so that you can have the differentiate between the three things. For example, now in the month of March to April, small size chocolates were sold 40 units, medium size chocolates were sold 25 units, and large size chocolates were sold for 50 units. For the first one, I have drawn the cluster bar diagram. The cluster bar diagram for small size 30. Again, remember to take the size of equal 10, 20, 30, 40 on x-axis, on y-axis, on x-axis. Remember, always years, months are taken on x-axis. This is x-axis and this is y-axis, and you should have the equal distance between two different percentage or months. For January and February, I have shown the three different bars, that is for small size 30, for medium size 15, so it will be somewhere between 30 and 20, that shows 15, and last size was 25. Here I have shown 50, but it should be 25, it will go somewhere here. So remember, according to the size given, you have to make the bars, and as they are joined together, it is said cluster bar diagram. The last bar diagram is divided bar diagram. As the name suggests, divided, two different things are divided in one single bar. Here you can see the datas of rural population and urban population in the same single bar. One single bar is divided for urban and rural. The blank one is for rural and the lined one is for urban. From January to February, the population for rural area was 30, while urban area was 40. Same way you can draw for the month of March to April, it will be 35 to 80. Just remember, this is your y-axis and this is your x-axis. Every time take your years, months on x-axis and whatever ratio is given on y-axis. But remember to have the equal intervals. If you are having intervals, so 5, then take 5, 10, 15, like that. Here we have taken the interval of 20. 0, this is 0, then from 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, and so on. So this way, remember always to take the intervals of equal size, and years will be taken on x-axis and all the variables will be taken on y-axis. This chapter contains many one-liners, multiple choice questions, 3-marker questions and even 5-marker question from the viewpoint of board exam. So I hope this will help you out in your preparation for your board exams and start learning. Have a good day and a healthy and a stay home and be safe. Thank you.